Out to the gunman. Tonight we learned he was wearing a bulletproof vest. One of the reasons it took a bomb to kill him. CBS 2's Danielle Nottingham is in Dallas tonight with the latest.
Police say this was a planned attack and the shooting suspect was waiting for the right moment to carry it out. Now a city is in grief and it's asking for the public's help to put itself back together.
People in Dallas are trying to understand why an apparent lone gunman murdered five of their police officers and injured seven more. Thursday night's shooting came as hundreds of people peacefully marched to protest the police shootings of two black men in Louisiana and Minnesota. The crowd fled in terror as the shots rang out. Police identified the gunman as 25-year-old Micah Xavier Johnson, a loner and former Army reservist who did one tour of duty in Afghanistan. Officials say he wore body armor and was armed with an SKS semi-automatic assault rifle and a handgun. The police chief says Johnson told officers he acted alone as they negotiated with him during an hours-long standoff in a parking garage.
The suspect said he was upset at white people. The suspect stated he wanted to kill white people, especially white officers.
Police killed Johnson with a robot-delivered bomb when talks failed. A search of his house revealed bomb-making materials, rifles and ammunition, bulletproof vests, and a personal journal of combat techniques.
Officials here in Dallas voiced a sense of relief when they determined it was likely one person who was responsible for the chaos.
We believe now that the city is safe and the suspect is dead and we can move on to healing.
Investigators say they interviewed 200 police officers and at least 12 fired their weapons Thursday night. In Dallas, Danielle Nottingham, CBS 2 News.
As Danielle mentioned, Dallas police used a robot equipped with an explosive device to kill the gunman. Police around the country, including the NYPD, have for several years used robots with remote control technology developed by the military. However, this is the first time a robot's ever been used to deliver lethal force.